I set targets for how I want to gently change, and I don't change like flip a switch. I know my life has momentum and it's moving in a direction already, and that if I try to just flip a switch, I'm going to fail. I need to gently move myself toward it. So that's why I like Target, because it's like a dartboard. You know, I'm slowly throwing those darts and moving myself closer to center to my goal rather than trying to do it immediately. Okay. So that's just some metaphor to help you guys out. The other thing is I have my perfect week and I do a weekly review. And of course, this is all tongue in cheek. There's no week that's perfect, but it's perfect for me every Sunday from 6 a.m. to 8 a.m. I have a perfect week planned out. And then the joke used to be, and then the first child wakes up and lets me know how we're going to be altering my day, right? So his big thing is just sit down with your calendar and take a look at your week. I choose Sundays. Some people prefer Mondays. It's up to you. Make sure you spend an hour just doing this. I have it down now to where I can do this in 6 or 7 minutes.
Hey, Janine. But,
yeah.
I have a sign, a door sign that speaks to what you just said.
Oh, really?
Your
well,
week.
Talk to us, Paul. What does it say?
It says, "We make plans, God laughs."
Exactly. Precisely, yeah. Though. Thank you so much, Paul. And we're going to introduce Paul here in a little bit, because he's somebody that is one of the 99 authors that was a part of the book, Published Profitability. He's one of our authors. This is what the downloadable looks like. We're going to pop that into the chat. Thank you, Lynette. We're going to pop this into the chat. So just make a copy of it. For those of you who don't use Google Docs very often, go into the top upper left-hand corner and make a copy of it, and you'll be able to edit it online. Or you can be old school like I am. I print this sucker out, and that way I have it pinned up where I can see it. I just need three-dimensional stuff sometimes. Just remember that when it comes to send out cards or your business, whatever it is you're doing, what you are doing, what you are creating for yourself are habits that are good habits. So often people are talking about making change because they're trying to alter negative habits or what they perceive to be negativity in their life. What I am like, you're moving toward a positive life. This is where you really want to change your mindset. I am moving in a positive direction. I am going into a place I haven't gone before. I may stumble. I'll have speed bumps. I'll have situations that work on that. But it all comes down to the choices that I'm making. And we talked about this last week. The choices that we make, we talked really quickly about the Eisenhower decision matrix. You can go look at the next previous Open Friday Coffee if you want to see more about this. It's how to make decisions quickly so that you can move on. The 4-week system you know about, prospecting, follow-up, connecting, and train yourself 1 hour a week. This is why I do Open Friday Coffees, is that you can come get a little bit of training each week, ask questions. We'll help you with that. We also, it's so important that when you're running a business that you measure your project progress. The thing is no matter what project you happen to be working on or whatever habit you happen to be working on, make sure that you have step-by-step kind of progress markers instead of I'm going to lose 50 pounds in the next 15 months or something like that. And all of a sudden, you know, you don't really measure your progress on it. You just have an end goal. It's important that you do what they call KPIs, key performance indicators. This is very big in business. And for those of you who've worked in corporate, you know that. How are you tracking your progress? This is something that is helpful that you do on your Sunday sit downs. Now, last week, we already talked about who do you already know? We have a downloadable for this, and Lynette, that's also in the links about who do I already know, who are your contacts. And so now to answer Susan and Cheryl's training, whenever you are doing Zoom anything and you know that you're going to be on Zoom every week with a certain person, do not rely on email services for your Zoom length, especially repetitive meetings. Make sure you book them and put them in your calendar. If you do not know how to use Google Calendar and set this up for repetitive meetings, I will be glad to go over that next week. But I really recommend that you put any meetings in your calendar. Do not rely on email. Okay, because email, there's too much quirkiness happening in the world today with technology. I I will be honest. Okay. Last week, I sent out 3,127 emails. I was doing a book launch, and it was amazing to me the number of people that didn't receive it, never heard of it, that sort of thing. Things were bouncing back. It was kind of crazy, all the stuff that we experienced. So just wanted to let you know, do not rely on email with your repetitive meetings. For Cheryl, it's time for us to answer some personal questions here. When it comes to the business that you are building, the idea that you had, you already know your why. You know why you're in business. You have a problem that you know you're going to solve. But before you start really working on the business side of it, we've got to talk about your lifestyle. It is very important that you build your lifestyle first and then fit your business into those cracks. So you want to know, when are you going on vacation this year? And if you say, like that, I'm like, immediately. Put a vacation down. I don't care if you're a startup. I mean, we all have heard about people who were successful, how they were sleeping. Like Elon Musk talks about when he was at Tesla, he was sleeping under his desk. They were, had all kinds of problems building out that car. He didn't take a vacation for I don't know how long. But just realize that for your business, you're working full time and you're building this business on the side. You've got to make sure you take vacation on that. Also with that, make sure that you do a business retreat once every quarter. I do this. I go out once every 3 months and I take a weekend and I'm just going to focus on my business. So make sure you take your business retreat. You're working on your business, but you're making sure you're in alignment with your vision. You're working on it. So I take those 4 times a year, right? Also, you want to build out what your income plan is going to be. We'll talk about most valuable product or minimum viable product that MVPs. Talk about how you're going to build out income. And as you know about me, because we already talked about this, I wait until the first person has purchased from me, then I build. I don't build and then sell. I build after I have proof of concept that somebody's going to buy that particular product from me. And then make sure you build out your lifestyle plan. So these are the 4 things that I think are most important before you ever start promoting a business. Now, here's some free stuff. I mentioned it last week, but we're going to mention it again. Lynette, if you'll be kind enough to put that in the link in the chat about free stuff. When it comes to conversations with people, I am noticing more and more that most conversations from my business people are all transactional. They have something they need, blah, blah, blah. They're trying to sell me something. It's buy my stuff, buy my stuff, buy my stuff. You want to stand out to where somebody will buy your stuff? You want to stand out on that phone call or that Zoom meeting? Don't sell. Ask them how their life is. Take notes. Find out if their dog just died. Find out if they just lost their housekeeper. Talk to them about them as a human being. And it is amazing how you will get much more traction and you'll have a long-term client. I don't want customers. I want long-term clients. I want people who come back year after year after year asking me to help them with solving whatever their problem is. That's where my mindset is, because I will be working till the day I die, but I'm going to be working my way. So this is the link you can go to, janinebolin.com/LinkedIn. Go ahead and ignore that short little $37 course. Just keep scrolling down and you'll see the free videos that are available there on there. Okay. Also, I wanted to remind you, please spend an hour a week where all you do is call people. And that means pick up the telephone. Now, some people say, oh, that's so rude. I would never call them. Most people allow it to go to voicemail. It's okay. What you do is you call them up, leave a voicemail, say, hey, I was thinking about you. I'd like your address. I want to send you a card. And then you go ahead. And then when you text them, you say, left you a voicemail, need your address. And then they can choose whether or not they listen to their voicemail or what have you. Okay. So one of those things that some people are like, oh, it's rude to do this, or, oh, people don't like that, or blah, blah, blah. I'm like, how do you know? I haven't had a person yet tell me, Janine, stop leaving me voicemails. You know what they say? Oh, it's so nice to hear your voice. I rarely get voicemail. Okay. So it just depends on your people, your demographic.